Hey everyone, Dylan Schumacher, Citadel Defense, and today we're gonna paint this. Just got a basic PSA AR-15 here today, and we're gonna paint it, and we're gonna paint it using masking. So masking, for those of you who don't know, is where you are going to coat the whole gun, put on little irregular shapes, coat the whole gun, put on little irregular shapes, coat and repeat, and then you take all the tape off at the end. When you coat it, you're coating it in different colors, and then as you peel off all of the tape, it's gonna reveal the different colors, and you get kind of like a woodland-like pattern, depending on the colors you use and the colors and the order in which you apply the color. Whatever you want to be your dominant color, apply that last. Whatever you want to be your least dominant color, apply that first, okay? That's kind of the general rule for masking. So I would take the colors I want, I rank them in order of what I want to be the dominant color themes, and then I would reverse it, and that's how I'm gonna apply them, right? So I'm gonna apply the colors I want to be the least dominant first, second, and third, and the ones that I want to be the most dominant last, right? So that's how it works, depending on how many colors you want to use and whatever. We are going to use four colors for this gun. We're going to use kind of a puke green, kind of this little puke green here. We're going to use a dark green, okay? We're going to use a khaki, and then we are going to use a dark brown. And that is actually the order in which we are going to apply them, so it's going to have a brown heavy finish, okay? To paint this gun, in case you don't know, the way we paint AR-15s, we're gonna take the stock all the way out. I took the rear sight off already, so we're not gonna worry about that. I will tape off the front sight, I will tape off the barrel, I'll put a mag in the gun. Other than that, I close the dust cover, leave the charging handle in, that's it. On this particular gun, I am gonna tape off the grip because it's kinda got this nice foamy rubberized grip thing here. It's super comfortable. So I'm gonna tape that off because we wanna preserve that. Other than that, we're just gonna let it ride and paint it. So the first coat, we will not tape anything off. We're just gonna get a base coat here, and that will be in the Puke Army Green, okay? And then after that, we'll start taping stuff off, and then we'll start coating again. I'm gonna wait about a day, at least overnight, between my coats. So this will be about a 4 or 5 day project, something like that, to get this thing complete, okay? That way, I like to let them all settle. That way, when you start ripping the tape off and stuff, you're not peeling other paints and whatever. So this one's important, in my opinion, to let them settle between coats, okay? The other ones, I don't like to wait very long, so I just give it 20 minutes and I just go. But for this one, this kind of painting system, I'm gonna wait it out. Okay, well, let's tape it up and get it painted. Here it is. That's how it turned out. I'm happy with it. This is basically what I intended. You know, really the sky is the limit with what you can do with the masking, right? And how big you want the shapes to be, or if you want them to be much smaller, you could use much smaller pieces of tape. That'll be much more tedious to remove and take off and all that stuff. But you could certainly do that. You know, this one ended up being a little bit larger with the pattern and the pieces of tape, and I really like how that turned out. Again, use whatever color you want to be your most dominant color last and kind of work up to that, because everything that's not covered then will be that color, right? Makes sense? So that's why I tend to work from least dominant color in my color scheme to most dominant color in my color scheme. If you want them all to be roughly even, then you just gotta, you know, manage your tape correctly. But this is it. This is the masking on the Air 15 and how that works. Give it a try. You know, it's a several day process. I think all in, this ended up taking me about 5 days. Because again, I tried to wait overnight between coats in order to really to get that effect. So that's all I got. Give it a shot. Let me know how it works. Do brave deeds and endure.